This Legends broadcast is brought to you by JCPenney, proud sponsor of your Texas Legends.
Exciting night as the Legends celebrate Pink Night here inside Dr. Pepper Arena. Let's take a look at the Home Depot shot chart featuring two Holloway last night as they took on the Raptors 905. Two, one of the only bright spots for the team from an offensive perspective last night in the 56-point blowout, shooting nearly 44% from the field. Tonight, the Legends shooting 46% as a team right now, trailing by one at halftime, certainly changing the tide of their shots and looking to get things moving early on inside, as the rule both before the game and at halftime from Coach Van Exel was simple. Penetrate, 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 and look to kick if we have to, but get to the rim and try to get easy opportunities. Jared, so far that lesson is working for this team, but Austin seems to be adjusting every once in a while and slowing things down when the Legends do have these cold streaks. Let's see what they can do to get warmed up from outside here in the second half.
Appreciate it, Travis, and time to take a look at our halftime statistics inside Dr. Pepper Arena with the Legends trailing the Spurs 47-46. Our statistics appropriately brought to you by NTT Data. You take a look at the rebounding disparity. The Spurs, one of the best rebounding teams in the D-League, and by some metrics, the best rebounding team, and they're putting that on demonstration tonight, out-rebounding the Legends by 12. According to rebounding percentage, which calculates the amount of rebounds a team gets relative to the amount of rebounds in which they had a player available to get that particular rebound, the Spurs lead the D-League, and they're outclassing the Legends in that department. And in a one-point game, rebounds, turnovers, any of these statistics could be the difference. Three-point percentage is something that is favoring the Spurs as well. 5 of 11 compared to 4 of 16 for the Legends. Two Holloway hitting a pair of threes for Texas, and he leads the Legends with 17 points. He's doing it outside, and as you see right there, he has done it inside as well. For the third straight game, all three games this homestand, Two Holloway is really leading the charge into the scoring department. They're getting a little bit out of Stephen Pledger, but he is still absent from behind the arc, which is supposed to be one of his calling cards. Pledger so far tonight getting a start for the Legends is just 1 of 4 from three-point distance. For the Spurs, they're led in scoring by Caddy Lalane. He's got 10 points, and that tells you that the Spurs really spreading it out. 6 for Deshaun Thomas, 9 for Kiefer Sykes, 5 for Julian Washburn, Nick Johnson with 3. Every Spurs player who has played tonight has scored at least a bucket as they continue to distribute the ball to different guys late in possessions. We talked about Fish before the game started and early into the game that this is a Spurs team that plays at a slow pace. And I think sometimes slow has a negative connotation. Slow doesn't mean bad. It could mean methodical. It could mean controlled.
Meticulous.
Meticulous. Yeah. Whatever word you want to attach, the Spurs play slow in a good way, and they're using that to generate offense from a number of different sources this evening.
Well, one of those sources, the jump out for me is Julian Washburn, who averages 3 points a game, hit a three. So he reached his average and made an impact late in that first half on the one single thing that he did right. But the Legends did so much right over the course of the last half of that second period defensively, as good a defensive stint as the Legends have had all season long.
As we start the second half of action, scoreboard brought to you by the fine folks at Dr. Pepper. Kiefer Sykes misses the up and under layup, and the Legends with a chance to take their first lead since the first quarter. Murray working it down low to Ashley. He gets doubled. Skip pass. Pledger. Here's Holloway. 5 on the shot clock. Takes it to the hoop. Leaning back, a high archer. He can't get it. Lalane snags the board.
Two looked at the shot clock and thought, do we have time to just reset the whole thing? Realized there was only 6 seconds left. So did what he could with the possession.
Another defensive stop for the Legends to start the half. And yet another chance to take their first lead since the first quarter. There was a nice halftime presentation raising awareness for breast cancer and honoring survivors of breast cancer. The Legends doing their part wearing the pink jerseys tonight. That shot was returned to sender with two hands. You don't see the two-hand block too often, but he got it there.
You might as well just grab it.
May as well. Bill Russell was so good at.
Yeah. 2 seconds left now on the shot clock. Got to catch it and throw it up there.
The lob. Ashley falling away. Oh, just out. Bill Russell so good at blocking shots to teammates, not just sending it seven rows into the crowd when he had the ability not to.
And that dopey R.J. Choppy and I argue about this all the time. He says, yeah, but what about the great momentum lift you get from slapping it into the 12th row? And I argue back, but what if you get the momentum lift because you slap it to your teammate who makes an uncontested layup 84 feet away?
Or the momentum that can be generated from not just the layup, but a dunk. You know, there are a lot of coaches who believe that the dunk adds momentum if you believe in that sort of thing.
Well, Choppy will be back here soon enough, and we'll put up with it.
Sykes in the foul. Kiefer Sykes got off to a quick start in the first half, then cooled down as the half progressed, but he's off to a nice start here in the second half with the bucket and a chance for another with the free throw attempt on its way.
Now, Jared, that slam dunk gives us momentum. I really do get that. But I also see, and I know you do too, so many guys that try the put-back slam dunk, for instance, and then it caroms off the back rim. To me, all you did was just miss a layup. So what does it do when you miss a dunk?
Well, I think an uncontested, we were talking about an uncontested shot.
Yeah.
And you don't see too many missed dunks at this level. It's a rare bird. But you're right. It's a missed opportunity to put 2 points on the board. Lalane off the glass, can't get it to go. Thomas, second chance, blocked. Legends with the ball, pushing the tempo. Holloway, nice look away pass, but Murray's shot's blocked from behind. Washburn directs it off course. And Lalane right down the heart of the lane with the bucket, and Nick Van Exel wanted a timeout. They didn't acknowledge it, and it almost resulted in a transition bucket for Teray Murray. He couldn't hang on. And now Nick Van Exel will call the timeout at 30 seconds. So we'll keep it here with our North Texas Trailer 30-second stoppage of play.
Yeah, Jared, there's no right answer. It's kind of like swinging for a home run. Hey, boy, if you hit a home run, that's really something. But sometimes a walk will do.
All right, if you're Nick Van Exel, Fish, what are you saying in this timeout?
They need to get back to the bread and butter of what was really working offensively, even though they didn't take every advantage of it. To Holloway's drive, and then the kick behind him to Jamil Wilson continues to be open anytime they want to run it. What they've done to start this half has been not so much Holloway as Murray as the trigger man. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but the Holloway and Wilson connection is there to be had.
Holloway will inbound, 21 on the shot clock, plenty of time. As Legends will get into some offense here. Holloway in front of the bench. From deep, can't get it to go. Rebound grabbed by Wilson. Feeding the cutting Ashley with the right hand from the left side.
Wilson follows up Holloway, both of them with some really clever passes.
Johnson, Thomas. Ashley on his back. Big 10 versus Pac-12, and Big 10 wins out as the former Buckeye gets the little baby hook over the former Wildcat. I guess you got to clarify because there's like 17 Wildcats, Arizona Wildcats.
There's only one Buckeye.
Ashley rattles it home. That one from three-point land, and it cuts the Spurs lead in half.
If you want to measure the desire of Nick Van Exel to get this game and get the four-game losing streak behind them and get up in the standings at Austin, he's even complaining after the made bucket by the Legends. He wants more. He wants better.
Spurs with numbers. Thomas, Washburn, can't get it to go. Good defense by Murray. He was the only one there. Ashley taking to the hoop, and we've got a charge. Lalane was waiting for him. And I wonder if Ashley is complaining that Lalane was in the circle. because it appeared pretty close or pretty clear that the lane was planted.
And you see Ashley measure it. He knows exactly what's happening.
Yeah, but that looked like the right call from my vantage point here, Fitch. The lane was outside the semicircle, and he was set. I don't know that you can get much more set than that. If you saw it differently, I don't know, but
yeah, no, and credit to Lalane at 6'9", being able to do that kind of defensive work.
And a technical foul called. Johnson knocks down the free throw.
Yeah, Ashley doesn't like it at all. And Ashley, in our experience, he's a sweet-tempered young man. But he's miffed right now.
We encourage you to get interactive with us here on the broadcast by tweeting questions to the Texas Legends Twitter account at Texas Legends. We got a question from Danny Fish, and Danny wants to know, Brandon Ashley made the D-League prospect watch. What does he bring to an NBA roster?
Well, he's got to get older. He is a baby. He's just a kid. And it would probably be beneficial to him to get thicker, if that's ever possible. As you see Brandon Ashley at number 24 on that prospect watch list.
And Orlando Johnson, who on that list was representing the Spurs, no longer with the Spurs. He's a part of the Phoenix Suns, signed to a 10-day contract. Maybe something that can happen to Brandon Ashley or others on that prospect list. Three-pointer hit by the Legends. They're back to within three, and we got a timeout on the fourth. 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it here. And they're changing it to a full, so it looks like we might step aside with 7:42 to play here in the third quarter, and we will step aside. The Legends hanging around. They're down by three on the Texas Legends Television Network. Central Kia has teamed up with the Legends this season to give away a brand new 2016 Kia Forte during the final home game. Sign up for free today at www.winanewkia.com or sign up at any Texas Legends home game, and you can triple your chances of winning by test driving a new Kia at any Central Kia dealership in Louisville, Plano, or Irving. The last home game for the Legends this season could mean more than just a simple win or a loss. It could mean playoff positioning. It could mean just getting into the playoffs. Looking at their schedule, their final home game, April 1st, against the Oklahoma City Blue. They'll close out their season against these very Austin Spurs in Austin the very next day. Legends coming out of the timeout in a zone, getting a stop on the first effort, but the Spurs will get a second chance with the rebound knocked out of bounds off of the Legends.
And that playoff chase, you know, over the course of 5 years, I've obviously grown to know Texas Legends folks pretty well. They pour their hearts into this thing. This staff is incredibly talented, and the work ethic is unmatched. And to have not just the players, but to have everybody involved in this organization get the reward of the experience of playoff basketball, it's being earned.
They're going to have to earn it on the boards tonight, which is a tough assignment against arguably the best rebounding team in the D-League based on certain metrics and rebounding, allowing the Spurs to keep possession here. Thomas, a skip pass. McCamey fakes. Johnson into the lane. Craftily getting his way to the cup, and on a second effort on this particular possession, he finishes.
Then there's R.J. Choppy, who wants the Legends to win a championship just so he can get a ring. He thinks he's going to get a championship ring.
Nothing wrong with a little championship bling bling. Murray, Wilson, three ball, and he rattles it home.
And Choppy is, he's the kind of guy that would walk, he would wear it every day. And show it off.
I guess if you got it, flaunt it, right?
And let kids and women try it on.
He'll sit at a booth and for a kiss on the cheek, you can try on the ring, right? Sykes with a little English, but Thomas puts it back with the left hand. Miller into the game for the Legends. Murray working on the much bigger Lalane. Wedger kicks to Murray into the paint. A little shimmy, a little shot, and a foul.
You know, Brandon Ashley not in the game now, so one of your thoughts, he's an all-star, of course, at the D-League level. One of your thoughts is, hey, if this group can just maintain. But as long as Murray and Holloway are on the floor, you're as good as it gets in the D-League backcourt. You don't have to just maintain. This group can go close this four-point deficit right now. Well, you know, in the next 48 seconds, let's say.
Some words there exchanged by Van Exel and members of the Spurs bench from across the sideline. I couldn't quite tell, and I mean this honestly, if he was lamenting with those on the Spurs bench that the referees just weren't making consistent calls, or if he was maybe telling those on the Spurs bench to quiet down. It's time for their silent, their reading voices, their library voices. Thomas, left hand to the cup. Deshaun Thomas with 12 points. Wilson straight away, trailing three, back rim. McCamey, a lead pass, Lalane behind the defense. Can't get the layup, but does get the foul, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
That's not really the Spurs bag right there, and maybe lulled to sleep for a moment, the Legends, that is. You may be aware when it comes to Thomas, you have to figure out whether or not you want to take the option of denying him the ball, because he's starting to cause you some trouble inside.
He's coming off season high 22 points on Wednesday. Into the game for the first time as a Legend, the newly acquired Cam Griffin, as he replaces Stephen Pledger. Griffin from Oklahoma, not the university, but just growing up in the state of Oklahoma.
And then played at the University of Denver.
And a addition recently, and the Legends were first exposed to him to the local tryout process. We'll see what he can do on the floor. But it's Miller here, and he draws the foul.
Cam Griffin completely plugged into, as you see Patrick Miller prepare to go to the line, completely plugged into Nick Van Exel. Comes right to the sideline to pick up all the instruction that he can gather.
And that's one of the challenges of the D-League season. You have so much player movement, and, you know, Fish, I think to minor league baseball where there's a ton of player movement, guys going up and down levels and getting released and guys getting signed. But baseball, though a team sport in a lot of ways, really is a sequence of individual events.
Right.
You need to make sure people have the same signs, they're on the same page there. But basketball, way more so than baseball, really relies on everyone on the court and on the team being on the same page on offense and on defense and understanding philosophies. That's a really tough challenge for Nick Van Exel or any D-League coach.
Yeah, you're saying if I can hit in the double-A level in baseball in Southern California, I can hit in the double-A level in South Carolina.
Well, listen, if you get called up from double-A to triple-A, when you step in the box, you know that you're just going to do what you've been doing for a long time. But
right.
When you get called from the Mongolian League to the Legends, you've got to know what they do on offense. You've
right.
got to know the flow offense. You got to know set plays.
You've got to
learn
the other
defensive
people.
Philosophies.
Yeah.
You got to know strengths and weaknesses of your teammate, if you're a point guard especially. As Miller up and under, a crafty finish. There are a lot of components that go into this. And later on, we'll get Travis Blakely's thoughts. He's getting moved around because he was stealing someone else's seat. We'll let him get settled. He's sitting in his spot. Travis, your thoughts, obviously, you're involved in the adding and subtracting of players, and I know you know how tough it is for any coach to deal with that in the game of basketball.
The difficulty in that is, as Fish described, getting up to speed. Lack of practice times this time of year in the season leads to pretty much film and shoot-around opportunities to get guys caught up, and it just doesn't always translate immediately to game action. So, you know, hats off to Stephen Pledger, who joined the team mid-road trip, this past road trip, and seemed to jump in rather seamlessly for a couple of games. Yet to be seen from Cam Griffin in regards to what he's going to be capable of doing tonight. But moving forward, he's got a couple practices to learn from, and obviously staying plugged into Coach Van Exel, as Fish said, is going to be critical.
Appreciate it, Travis.
Now,
Sean Thomas
Frank.
On the line for the Spurs.
And he's causing that trouble, isn't he? And frankly, with the newcomer Griffin, now you are just trying to stay afloat. But you're down seven, maybe about to be eight, with 4 minutes left in the third. But I don't know that you're saying, okay, Cam Griffin's on the floor, let's explode now as a five-man unit. I think you try to survive with him on the floor.
Spurs have grown their lead to eight as Holloway turns it over. Washburn in transition, gonna take it himself, and at an awkward angle, he lays it in, adjusting his body midair. And we got a timeout called by Nick Van Exel and the Legends, with the Spurs back out to a double-digit advantage. We're going to step aside from Dr. Pepper Arena with 3:46 to go in the third quarter. More Texans Legends basketball coming up after this. Spurs back out to a 10-point lead, 3:46 to go in the third quarter, but the Legends, using some outside shooting from Jameel Wilson, are hanging around, and Jameel Wilson is the subject of our legacy plumbing drain of the game. Patrick Miller with a nice little up and under there. And you see here, it's Patrick Miller who's stealing the spotlight from Jameel Wilson for our drain of the game. A crafty finish there from the sixth man tonight for the Legends.
Miller will take a breather now. Bobby Ray Parks Jr., part of the rotation now for the pink-clad Legends.
You can tell which team's the Spurs, and then by deduction, which team's the Legends, but it's a different jersey every night for the Legends, and we're raising awareness for breast cancer and honoring breast cancer survivors, both in here, in this building, and outside of the building.
I do like those Legends shorts. I might.
The pink shorts?
Yeah, pink and the gray, right? Is that gray?
Yeah, it looks like gray with a little bit of white as well.
I'm gonna go talk to somebody about that.
Jameel Wilson at the line for the Legends. And the Marquette product knocks down his first free throw. Wilson played for Buzz Williams in college. Williams has since taken a job to try and restore the Virginia Tech basketball program, but when he coached Jameel Wilson, he called him switchable because his ability to guard multiple positions on defense and fill a variety of roles offensively, and the Legends have seen Jameel Wilson have that type of an impact this year. 17 points and 8 rebounds for Wilson tonight to go along with 3 assists after making both those free throws. Washburn backing down Griffin and short on the fall away, but Thomas the offensive rebound. Second chance, can't get it to go.
Well, Thomas is the challenge right now for Wilson and the rest of the Spurs. He is really showing the capability of taking over inside.
14 points for Thomas. Holloway to the hoop, and he gets fouled. Holloway with a quiet second quarter, and really for the most part, a quiet third quarter.
And yet,
he's still tied for the team lead with 17 points due to the quick start that he had tonight.
That's his MO, really. Because he's doing so many things to have his hands on the steering wheel of the basketball team and is not necessarily looking to score first every time, but by the time the box score is done, he's your first scorer.
He's 4-4 from the line after making the front end of his two shots. Satnam Singh back in the game for the Legends. Kiefer Sykes, Dimitri McKamey back into the game for the Spurs. Holloway's out of Xavier and really had an interesting go of things. While he was at Xavier, he was involved in an on-court brawl, if you will, when Xavier took on rival Cincinnati. Holloway, who's one of the leaders of that Xavier team, was in the thick of things and received a lot of criticism from folks. And talking to Nick Van Exel the other day when we asked him if he's an NBA player, Nick said yes, he thinks he is, and really believes that he's a much better guy than people give him credit for, and that people are maybe hanging on to that one incident a little too long, and it's unfairly labeled him as perhaps a bad guy or somewhat of a risk.
Almost without prompting, Nick Van Exel, coach of the Legends, tells us he hasn't given me 1 second of issues. He's been all about, to Holloway, all about doing the right thing here.
He was the 2011 Atlantic 10 Conference Player of the Year and named to several All-America teams. A guy that's had success at a big stage at the college level. Five on the shot clock. Pledger's got to put it up. And it's in and out.
That's too bad, because that's a contribution from Singh there. Sent a really good screen, legal screen up there to help free the shooter.
Here's Lalane. Can't get it to go, but Singh with the rebound.
And I got to give you that shot every time.
Pledger, three ball. Gets it to go.
And you can't give me that shot, not from what we've seen out of Pledger.
Pledger now 2 of 5 from behind the arc tonight. 1 point game. 90 seconds to go in the third quarter.
This is your Bob Ortegal close the quarter strong moment right here.
Lalane has it poked away. Griffin pulling it out. Pledger, he's feeling it. Taken to the hoop. Tried to drop it off, but no one was there. Spurs in transition and a smart foul by Tu Holloway. Had he not done that, it would have been an easy bucket for the Spurs.
And that momentum-grabbing bucket, quite possibly, that we talked about earlier. That would have quieted the crowd at a time when you don't need that.
That's Holloway's second foul. Next foul committed by the Legends will send the Spurs to the line, so they had one to give. A heads-up play there by Holloway. Pledger on the back of Lalane. Baseline spin, drops it off, and Doye with the finish. Nice little block-to-block combination there.
Looked designed, didn't it?
Well executed.
Yeah.
Spurs back out to a three-point lead. Griffin gets cut off. Five on the shot clock. Parks, three ball to tie. And it nestles on the back rim. Sykes tracks down the rebound. Griffin almost takes it away, but it's out of bounds, and the Spurs will have a chance for a possession late here in the third quarter. I doubt they'll heave one up early for a 2-for-1, but with an 8-second difference, game clock to shot clock, they'll milk it for all it's worth. And it's really no different than any other possession. They like to work late into the shot clock.
Need to stop here, reminiscent of what you did in the last 7 minutes of the second quarter, a time that really turned this game around.
Sykes, 14-footer, off the iron. Parks the board, and the Legends can hold for one. Five on the clock. Singh setting a screen for Holloway. 1 second left. The layup, and it doesn't go. He got a little too deep underneath the hoop. Nick Van Exel wanted a call. He didn't get it. As we go to the break, 12 more minutes to go. The Legends trailing the NBA D-League's top team by 3. Can they pull out a win at home? We'll find out more when we come back on the Texas Legends Television Network.
Joined now as we approach the fourth quarter by Coach Martin Knezevich. And Coach, close game, three-point game. This team's played 3 games in 4 nights, a double overtime game included. Does fatigue play a factor tonight?
Hopefully not. Definitely didn't play a factor in the beginning. We went to the rim a lot, lived in the paint, still getting in the paint. Just got to clean up a little bit of the mistakes when we get in there, finding our shooters.
It appears some of the mistakes tonight have occurred in transition, particularly moving from offense to defense. What do you do to improve in those areas this final quarter?
Listen, we just have to focus on being us. I think sometimes we play opponents, we get a little rattled, we lose our identity a little bit. Our identity is to get up and down, space the floor, and equal opportunity shots.
How has the zone formation defensively helped this team not just stay in the game, but get back when the Spurs have taken a lead?
A lot. To be quite honest, it's just rest a bit. You know, we talked about staying aggressive at halftime, and the zone lets you do that because you're saving energy so you can go and attack them on offense.
Coach Martin, I appreciate your time. Good luck this final 12. Jared, over to you.
Thanks, Travis. Thanks, Coach. Fourth quarter underway. Washburn, corner 3. Offline, but a second chance opportunity created by the Lalane rebound. And Doye working with Wilson on his back. A lot of contact, and the whistle blows. Looks like Ndoye is going to go to the line to shoot two. Unless they say it was on the floor, that will be 2 shots. Scoreboard this quarter brought to you by the Home Depot. The And Doye at the free throw line so far tonight. One of two as he sinks that one on the season. And Doye is a 70% free throw shooter.
Yeah, Nick Carlisle. I'm sorry, Nick Carlisle. That's a good one, though.
That is.
Nick Van Exel is indeed barking back down at the Austin bench.
Miller, low pass to Parks, otherwise he might have had a three-point look. Miller hesitating, attacking, and he draws the foul.
Meanwhile,
Spurs Nick, lobbying for a clearance, but they don't get the call.
And then Nick's going to call a conference with Wilson. I'll say this about the Legends offense. Two's got to touch the ball on every trip. Every trip. He's your best scorer. He's your best decision maker. And if you're, say, Jamil Wilson, he's Jamil Wilson's best chance to score. Let two help you do that.
Miller splits the pair. It's a four-point game.
By the way, regarding the zone defense, coach is right about it in his discussion with Travis Blakely. But a smart team, and Austin is that, can find holes in it, seams in it.
Seems like the zone defense can work in spurts, but it can't work over the course of a game at this level. McCamey with a hand in his face sinks the three.
Yeah, for one thing, because I can shoot over it. I can also go get mismatches easier. It's kind of like, to use a baseball analogy, you can't throw a changeup. Your changeup can't be your out pitch. Because I know a changeup is coming, I'm going to hit it 450 feet. Would that be long enough to get it out of here, 450 feet?
That would be long enough to get it out most places. All of them these days. Wilson fakes the three. A little too hard for Parks. He corrals it, though, and lays it in with his left.
It's unorthodox, but the Legends are benefiting from little Patrick Wilson doing inside work. Patrick Miller, I'm sorry.
Nick Carlisle, Patrick Wilson.
And then what did we do the other night when I was doing Travis Frederick on the sideline? Remember that one?
Did you say Travis Frederick? No. He called me RJ. We should just call him Travis Cuban or Donnie Blakely. Travis, your thoughts? Should we go to either? You'll take either?
I'll take either.
If you get the last name Cuban, you probably have a much larger inheritance than if you keep the last name Blakely. I could be wrong, though. I guess I don't know for sure.
Yeah, Travis Blakely's going to make his basketball fortune on work ethic. He is, I'm not just saying this because he's listening, and Legends fans and Mavericks fans should know this. He's just highly regarded up and down both organizations for his willingness to just grab a broom and let's go.
Well, he came from a great high school, Fish, so.
Ah.
We have an interactive question from Roberta, Travis. With the Legends making a playoff push, how do the D-League playoffs work?
Well, after all those compliments, I'm tickled pink over here, Fish.
Yeah.
But I'm sorry, Jared, if you would repeat that question, you guys were breaking up on me a little bit.
Yeah, Roberta wants to know, with the Legends making a playoff push, how exactly do the D-League playoffs work?
Oh, well, it's a unique situation because only four teams from each division, or each conference rather, the East and the West, are selected. Right now, the Legends are tied for that final spot, and the first two slots are designated purely for the conference champions. So once those first two are gone, it goes to the two teams with the next best record, which means you could wind up with three teams coming out of the same division making the playoffs.
The Legends chasing the Austin Spurs, who, if the season would end today, would hold one of the two automatic spots in the Western Conference. The Legends essentially fighting for a wild card spot. Lalane rocking to the hoop. Thomas, one on a shot clock, and he gets the baseline jumper.
He's the troublemaker, and you've got to stick with him. He sets a screen high, then goes to the right side, sets another screen, and the whole intention is not for him to screen for other people. The intention for him is to eventually come off the screen and get the ball.
Miller from 19 feet, back rim, but Pleasure keeps the possession alive. Ashley and LaLanne. Ashley's been quiet tonight. Corner three for two and the foul. And it looks like with the contact, Holloway, a little ginger with the ankle. Not sure if he caught a little bit of an open chair there on the sideline.
Caught a fan's foot.
You say a fan's foot.
Yeah, so Julian Washburn is saying it wasn't me, but somebody fouled him over there. Maybe it was somebody's Nike.
Two for three with a chance for four. And a rare free throw miss. But the Legends back within four.
That's bad mojo right there. Okay, watch Thomas now, 23. He's setting screens, but he's not just being an offensive lineman. It's to get him the ball.
Ashley and LaLanne tangled up, and one of the reasons why we really haven't heard much from Brandon Ashley is because of foul trouble, and that right there is his sixth foul. Brandon Ashley is disqualified for the remainder of the ballgame. 8:07 to play, too. A lot of time left to lose your only active All-Star.
And you don't like to lose it on what you think is ticky-tack. And you don't like to lose it on a play where the ball wouldn't go into the rim, he wasn't touching the ball. And Nick Van Exel is livid about the Ashley call.
Loose ball, who's gonna get it? Holloway gets dirty, but unfortunately not rewarded. But you love the efforts and to see leadership like that from a guy who's maybe as taxed physically as two has been tonight, playing nearly 35 minutes, leading the team. 22 points for Holloway, leading the team as well.
That was almost a secondary break off a baseline inbounds, full court. That wasn't good.
And there's a wet spot on the court. And it was right around the area where the loose ball and the players met about 20 seconds ago. So they'll get that all taken care of. Thankfully, Patrick Miller, who hit the deck, is okay. Or appears to be okay.
You feel this thing, Jared Sandler, even though the scoreboard says it's only a six-point deficit, you feel this thing on the verge of slipping away. You just lost your other All-Star, in addition to Michael Eric, the All-Star not playing tonight, Brandon Ashley, to a foul and a surplus of fouls that you didn't think was a foul at all. You're having a very difficult time figuring out how to stick with Deshaun Thomas. And two Holloway missed a free throw.
Pleasure. Miller, three ball. Loose ball fought for. And it's going to stay here as Jamil Wilson was working hard to keep things going for the Legends. We saw the standings there a second ago. You know, Fish, the Legends were 15-10 at one point. That's the best record the Legends have had through 25 games in franchise history. They've lost four straight since, trying to keep it from extending to five straight. And it really hasn't gotten better for them at home. The homestand started on Wednesday. They lost a tough one in double overtime to the Iowa Energy before getting pummeled last night by the Raptors squad by 56. And you're hoping maybe that they could use this home court advantage against a really good Austin team. And still with a shot as Wilson knocks it down, four-point game.
And in that four-game streak, no singular pattern. Maybe you lost on the road because Michael Eric had the high ankle sprain. Then you lost in double overtime to Iowa. Then you lost by a million points last night. There is not a singular problem. And that in itself is a whole other problem.
LaLanne gets fouled. Now, one of the challenges for this Legends team, the Spurs, though they might have a lineup out there right now where the tallest guy is 6'9",
yep.
They also have 6'7", and 6'8". And especially with Brandon Ashley unavailable, you look at the Legends, and You've got 6 feet, 6'2", 6'4", 6'1", 6'7". Tough matchups for the Legends against a much bigger Spurs team, even if they're lacking that towering presence.
And they do have length on the floor, and then they have interchangeability. One of the things that about the Golden State Warriors, the world champions, that's so underrated there is they have the interchangeable parts. They can, for instance, on defense, if you try to run a pick and roll on them, they'll switch it. They don't care. Because the other guy is as good a defender against you as the former guy was against you. And maybe these Spurs could do some of that as well with this group. And maybe that's one of the reasons their record is as good as it is.
3-point game. Johnson with 10 on the clock. Around
watch
the
Thomas.
Top of the screen. Yeah. Rolling, spinning, laying it in.
Are you sick of me saying it? That's the guy.
I think Nick Van Exel is probably sick of thinking about it. Pledger, three ball. He hits it. It's a 2-point game, Fish, with everything that has seemingly worked in favor of the Spurs.
Yeah.
The Legends are hanging around.
Watch 23 now.
He's got the ball and gives it up, but here he comes. I think
he's
going to
get it back.
And he passes it to no one. And with 5:59 to go, we'll have a break in the action. The Legends are hanging around. The little brother, pesky, and always there. Can they take advantage? We'll have to find out when we come back. 89-87, the Spurs on top on the Texas Legends Television Network. Let's take a look at the Chicago De Oro shot of the game. 89-87, the Spurs over the Legends. Our shot of the game comes from Jamil Wilson, a three ball that rattled home earlier in this contest. And Jamil Wilson so far tonight in 37 minutes has dropped 22 points to go along with 10 rebounds, a double-double for Jamil Wilson. And the Legends are going to have to count on him to give some production with 5:59 to go. They're without Michael Eric due to injury. And Brandon Ashley has fouled out in just 14 minutes. So both Legends All-Stars not going to be on the court the rest of the way as they try to come back and topple the D-League's best team.
And maybe you've milked all you're going to milk out of Singh tonight. And maybe you've milked all you're going to milk out of the newcomer Griffin tonight. So you've got 5:59. And you've probably got five or six guys that are going to have to make it all go.
Legends with the ball down two. Miller aggressive with the ball. The foul and the bucket. They gave him continuation, and this ball game is tied. And it takes some athleticism, Fish, to be able to withstand that contact and still be in a position to possibly finish. Look, Sykes hits him, and Miller staying on his feet, able to scoop it in. Can't get the free throw, though, and that elusive lead remains just that, elusive.
Yeah, if the category is, can you muscle your way to the basket as a little guy, relatively, yeah, he can muscle.
Turnover, traveling, 5:32 to go, and if the Legends could take the lead, it would be their first since the first quarter, and I imagine it would get this crowd going. This is a very nice crowd in attendance here tonight, and they're just dying to see the Legends have more in the points column than the Spurs.
Yeah, and it's not their responsibility to pump you up.
Pledger for the lead.
It's your responsibility to do that, and it boomerangs back to you.
Legends up by three. First lead since they were ahead 21-18. Sykes, corner three, and we are tied back up. Nick Van Exel wanted a 3 seconds call against Caddy LaLanne, but he didn't get it. Miller, kicking it out to Holloway. Cut off by Johnson. Miller hesitated, now takes it. Lead back for the Legends. Tell you what, Fish, this is more fun than losing by 56, I'll tell you that.
Well, this looks like a team that thinks we really do deserve to be in the playoffs. Let's work to get there.
Sykes, back rim. Thomas keeps it alive. There's Sykes in the lane, and he gets it to go. That's 22 for Kiefer Sykes. You can see him at the All-Star festivities participating in the slam dunk contest. Miller really taking it on his shoulders, and he's going to get fouled and go to the line.
Well, he finds himself guarded by Lalane, who not going to be able to, at 6'9", handle Patrick Miller in the open court. So that's easy pickings.
Miller not used to being a guy that the Legends rely upon for some offensive production, but he's certainly given it to them here tonight. As he hits the front end, Miller this season has scored over 20 points just once, but he's got 18 so far. His season high was 22 points earlier this year. And that came against Idaho. He's got 19 with that, and the Legends back out to a three-point lead. Johnson to Thomas. 10 on the shot clock. Lalane, corner three, and we're tied. Caddy Lalane with points 20, 21, and 22.
And you'll notice Patrick Miller, still the guy who's bringing the ball up the floor.
Wilson fires a three. He knocks it down. A three-point barrage for the Legends. Timeout, Austin. And it's Texas that reaches the century mark first tonight. A full timeout, 3:24 to go inside a rowdy Dr. Pepper Arena. And we're gonna step aside. Exciting basketball for you tonight on Texas 47. And more coming your way next. Time for the Frisco Shuttle drive of the game as we return to Texas Legends basketball. It's Patrick Miller who has 19 points tonight, taking it to the cup. And he's a big reason why the Legends lead 197 against the D-League leading Austin Spurs. Now it's about closing it out, Fish. So if you're Nick Van Exel, what are you telling your team in that most recent huddle?
It's certainly been a Patrick Miller mini show, largely because he's recognizing that he's got a matchup advantage. Ultimately, though, here in the next 3:24 and real quick, it needs to shift into the two Holloway show.
The Legends are led in scoring by Jameel Wilson with 25, two Holloway with 22, and then it's Miller with 19. Spurs with the ball out of the timeout. Johnson and Wilson collide, and a block is called on the moving Wilson as he was bulldozed by the smaller Johnson. Both players appear to be shaken but not stirred, if you will. Just how Travis likes his drinks, I'm told. Isn't that right, Travis?
That is correct, sir.
Yeah, that could have been a left wrist.
You know, it's tough when you're not anticipating the contact and it didn't appear like Jameel Wilson was ready for that. You're also not as prepared to brace yourself or get your body in position to withstand it.
Yeah, initially I thought that he may have been hit in a sensitive spot, but he's holding his left wrist, left hand.
Well, he is a right-handed player for whatever that's worth. And he's gonna stay in the ball game.
Yeah, if you can, you see him in the center of the floor underneath the basket. He's not doing much with his left arm.
Sykes, an open three, but he's short. Murray the rebound. The Legends can make this a multiple possession game for the first time since the first quarter. They led 21-13 at one point. Pledger to the cup and the scoop.
Well, there's been a handful of times tonight when Pledger, who by reputation is a three-point marksman, has taken it to the hole. A big benefit for the Legends. Now up five.
They finished third in career three-pointers at OU, but he's done it inside the three-point line tonight. He's got 18 points for the Legends.
Austin sneaks baseline there. That's a no-no. I'm not sure Wilson, and we'll see, and I hope I'm wrong, I'm not sure he's capable of doing very much.
Miller hanging and banging. How'd he get that one to go? And we got a 30-second timeout called by the Spurs. And you know, Fish, you mentioned that about Wilson, and some people might wonder, well, just get him out of the game. The problem is your options are big man Satnam Singh, not a likely replacement for Jameel Wilson. You got Brandon Ashley, he's fouled out. Cam Griffin's new and probably not a guy you want to play in crunch time, because I can't imagine he's too familiar with everything that the Legends are doing. And then it's Bobby Ray Parks Jr., and clearly Nick Van Exel at this point feels more comfortable with Wilson over Parks, and Parks defensively probably not going to be able to give you what Wilson can, because Wilson is kind of playing the role of your center right now.
Now, the medical staff goes over to Wilson and says, how are you doing? He says, I'm all right. But on two straight offensive trips, it looks to me like he's signaled to another member of the Legends, you take my spot. You take my role. Maybe being the high screener and then come off for a pick and pop. But he's still holding the left wrist. So it's still problematic enough that I think it's an easy prediction to say that asking him to now go shoot a bunch of jump shots, that's not going to fly.
Legend shooting 75% this quarter. Keeper Sykes can't get it to go, but Johnson on the second effort gets it to fall. It stays a three-point game as the Spurs out-rebounding the Legends 45-28.
Now this time, Jameel Wilson says, I'll take it myself. I'll do my regular role. You see that?
Miller spinning in the mid-range J. Wilson set the screen, but Miller did the dirty work down low. Nice bounce pass from Johnson to LaLanne, but LaLanne couldn't hang. And with 80 ticks left, the Legends lead by 5. A great fourth quarter so far for Patrick Miller. Can he keep it going? Just short. Johnson pushing to Sykes. The trees send him back. And it looks like Pledger and Wilson are arguing. I think Wilson's wondering why Pledger didn't secure the basketball near the sideline. 18 on the shot clock after that rejection off the hand of Wilson.
How fast can he get 66 seconds off your clock?
Johnson to Sykes with 10 on the clock, and we got a foul. Miller got a little handsy with Sykes.
Or Sykes did that swim through move with the ball, where I swing my arms into your arms.
Either way, Miller,
yeah,
with the infraction, and Sykes will go to the line. And this is what you don't want. You're asking how quickly can you get these seconds off the clock. Well, nothing's moving right now when you're at the free throw line. Sykes misses the front end.
That was way to the right. You don't see that out of a little guy free throw shooter very often. Maybe this one will be way to the left.
And he gets it to go with a little
right
help
too.
From the iron.
Yeah.
All right, Legends up 4 inside of a minute.
You notice now Holloway, and with no disrespect to anybody else who's done a great job here, but Holloway's in charge.
Maybe a little acting there from Johnson. Wilson, open 3, and it's short. But Murray with the rebound. And that's huge. The Spurs have to foul now. With 36 and a half seconds left, Terray Murray will go to the free throw line. And on the season, Murray is shooting 66% from the stripe. So far tonight, Murray at the free throw line is 2 for 2.
Well, two huge things happened there. One, the carom was huge, because the Legends didn't exactly deserve that rebound. It just bounced their way. But two, the shot taken by Jameel Wilson demonstrates that, and then his actions afterwards demonstrate that his left wrist is fine, and that's really big news.
Murray makes it, it's a 6-point game, and he does. It's worth noting the Spurs, the second best three-point shooting team in the league. We'll see what they do here. Johnson attacking, kicking. Washburn almost loses it. Corner three, Thomas is short. Johnson the rebound. What do we have? It's out of bounds and it's going to be off the Legends.
Texas found itself a way to double team the ball almost everywhere it went up until that final corner shot. Terrific
and
work.
The Legends are going to ask for a review, I believe. Let's see here is Johnson. Oh, heads up play. Yes, it did hit Lalane last, but it doesn't matter because he threw it off Jameel Wilson while Wilson was out of bounds. That's a really heads up player from the veteran Nick Johnson, who is really well seasoned from his time playing big time basketball at Arizona under the great Sean Miller.
The officiating crew is going to take a hard look at this. Probably see what you saw.
It's a worthwhile challenge, especially when you consider that I'm sure Nick Van Exel's squad with a short bench could use this extra pseudo timeout.
No question about that.
We're looking right here at what the referees are seeing. So here's Johnson. He's inbounds right there, it appears. A little bit of rewind here. And he throws it off of Jameel Wilson, who's out of bounds. The only other thing I could think of, did he travel? But looking at it right there, it does not appear that Johnson took an extra step. And who knows what traveling is these days anymore anyway. That's a really heads-up play by Johnson. Whether it's going to be enough to help the Spurs climb out of the six-point deficit, well, that's what we're about to find out. Nick Van Exel's got to be telling his team, nothing stupid, nothing silly, play good defense. If they have a shot, let them take it. Let's not try to create more for the Spurs out of nothing, but let's just play good, solid defense.
Yeah, now, if you allow Thomas to be completely free inside, Austin will take that shot. Everything doesn't have to be threes. So you'd sure like to keep him 15 feet away from the basket.
Sykes, quick three, hits it. And they're going to review it. And because of the situation, they're going to review it automatically without allowing play to continue. Travis, we've seen before referees review calls moments later, minutes later, when we go to a break, but right now we don't wait because of the situation of the ball game.
The situation dictates that we need an answer now. The thing to consider here too, that's kind of a tangential portion of what's going on, this allows Austin to huddle up multiple times without using timeouts at a critical point in the game, and allows Coach Ken McDonald to draft up defensive schemes, future offensive play calls. Certainly not something that Coach Van Exel, I'm sure, is looking forward to having happen again, which would be another referee play, as Mike Fisher likes to call it.
Hey, Travis, let me ask you this. So you've got the Spurs being able to draw things up. You've got the Legends with, let's see, three guys who have played over 40 minutes and another who's approaching 40 minutes getting some extra rest. Do you think that the Spurs still have more an advantage with the timeouts versus the Legends getting some rest?
I do. If you take note, these guys aren't allowed to sit down during the replay. So they're on their feet. And at this point, the adrenaline is at such a high level that fatigue, these guys are pros. It's not really going to settle in any more so than it has in the last 3.5 minutes versus the final 30 seconds of the game. Right now, being able to slow your team down and say, hey, here's what we're looking to accomplish schematically, that's a bigger advantage than any sort of rest gained to prevent fatigue.
All right, well, they're still looking at it.
I wish they could look at it and realize that the shooter took about four little chippy, chippy, chippy steps.
All right, well, Travis, is that something that they can review in this situation?
They cannot come back and call a travel. No, all the right. Only determination they can make right now is whether it was two or three.
Which, by the way, is one of the bones I have to pick with referee play.
Well, but let me ask you this, because, Travis, could Nick Van Exel challenge that there was a travel? We saw earlier this week a challenge of an offensive call versus a block. Could Nick Van Exel have initiated a challenge to maybe test whether or not steps were taken?
No, because it has to be an if one or the other situation, and that would be a determination that would have to have been called on the court. He could have challenged that particular call if it was called a travel on a Legends player. In this situation, he can't challenge the non-call.
All right, you look on the screen here. You've got some of the better free throw shooters for the Legends. All of them but Parks on the floor out of this timeout. And now the Legends are going to call a timeout to advance the basketball with 20.9 seconds left. This is simply an advanced timeout. They're not going to huddle.
For the sake of comedy, I wish you could challenge a challenge. And if you don't like that, challenge it.
We'd be here forever. Holloway gets it. That's the guy you want to get it, a 90% free throw shooter. He splits the trap and gets fouled.
Boy, you nailed it, Jared Sandler. You stepped through the double team. And that's why you want the ball in two's hands. I don't know that everybody on this roster or most rosters is cool and calm enough and textbook enough and maybe even small enough to sneak through that little gap.
Well, big miss there from two. They need him to make this one to make it a two-possession game.
He's missed a couple, highly uncharacteristic for him.
Now, all the way from the line tonight, 5 of 7. And he misses the second. Timeout Spurs. They're going to have the ball down three. A 90% free throw shooter missing a couple of free throws, and he's not happy about it.
I may have thrown an unorthodox jinx at Tu Holloway by pointing out his calm and his cool on the step through the double team. And then he doesn't exhibit that, oddly for him, at the free throw line.
It is simply an advanced timeout.
That's rough.
Well, this advanced timeout has turned into something of a 20-second timeout. Nick Van Exel pointing out that Coach McDonald over there drew up a play. And it was simply supposed to be a timeout that allows you to advance the basketball. It turned into a little bit more. We'll see how the Spurs take advantage of it. They're down three, but they don't have to get a three. Lalane, pressured by Pledger. And he drops it off, no one there, but Johnson gets the deflection. Sykes, Thomas for the tie. Short, Johnson with a put back in and out, and he puts it back in a foul. A third effort. And Nick Johnson with a chance to send this to overtime or tie the game with a free throw.
And Nick Van Exel saying, you know what? I do want to challenge the challenge of a challenge.
All right, so Travis, right here we have a challenge. We're challenging a foul, so help us explain why this right here is challengeable.
You can challenge the call. You cannot challenge a non-call.
There you go. So earlier they didn't call the travel. They could have challenged if a travel was called, perhaps. Here the foul was called, so they're going to challenge whether or not it was a foul. Credit to Nick Johnson. He's 6'4", for springing back up to keep that possession alive.
Yeah, the athleticism to on that second jump, because that's tough. And you try to do that when you're playing junior high basketball and your coach tries to teach you to do that, and it's not easy for all of us. Now, if we can, I'd love to take a look not just at Johnson's work underneath, but the chance. There's a loose ball out there 5 seconds before this, and it's going to be the Legends' ball.
Well, right here, let's take a look at this replay, Fish. It does look like that's a foul. I mean, Stephen Pledger contacts him right near the head, between the head and the shoulder. Now, what are you saying here?
5 seconds before this, the Legends have the game won. There's a loose ball in the backcourt. Two Legends are getting ready to decide who's going to pick it up, and somehow the ball ping-pongs back and forth between them and back into the hands of Austin. And then we have this result.
So we're waiting the referee's decision. And it really does look like Pledger fouls him. Yeah, you can see he gets him in the head, too. I mean, not that it should be a flagrant, but...
No. But this is a This is a brand new and creative way to turn a certain victory into something less certain.
And if you're Stephen Pledger, there's no reason why you even need to contest that. As they confirm the ruling on the floor, if
Stephen Pledger
doesn't contest it, it's a made bucket, and then the Legends are going to have a
point, a second,
and change to just either run out the clock or get the ball and just go to the free throw line.
What a great observation, Jared Sandler, about a don't foul anybody situation.
And they're going to add 0.6 seconds, so there's 1.8 seconds left. Nick Johnson at the line with a chance to tie the game. And on the season, Nick Johnson at the free throw line is a 76% shooter. Tonight, he's 1 for 1. In and out. The clock goes for the win. It's no good. And the Legends hold on. It wasn't easy even after the missed free throw. But the Legends get the win as the losing streak comes to an end. And the Legends take down the best team in the D-League. 108-107 the score. Let's look at it again. He misses the free throw, but the putback almost went for the win right here. But LaLanne came up short, and the Legends come up big here inside Dr. Pepper Arena. The postgame show is next on the Texas Legends Television Network. We're smiles tonight, Mike Fisher, because on the North Texas Trailer postgame show, we get to tell everyone about a Legends win, and it was a fun game, 108-107, back and forth late, and a little bit of dramatics at the end. We'll talk about that coming up here on the North Texas Trailer postgame show. Time now for our player of the game. And how about Patrick Miller? He wasn't the leading scorer. Patrick Miller with 19 points, but this is just not the type of production the Legends are used to getting out of Patrick Miller. He really stepped up in that fourth quarter for this Legends team.
Well, and he saw a matchup advantage, because I don't think this was in the game plan for the Legends to have three guys score 20 or so. But time and time again, Patrick Miller would come down the floor, as you see, and see a win. And so he took the win.
When we come back, we will review the difference maker of the game, but Travis Blakely standing by with Patrick Miller.
Guys, I wish I could pass along all the compliments you just gave him, but I think he knows how great of a game he just had. Pat, huge difference maker for this team in the second half. What do you attribute that to, and what was the kind of overall change in the locker room as you guys came out of the half and really took it to the Spurs?
Coach just said, play the same way we played the first half with the small group we went out there with. He said we was playing good, and we had a lot of energy. We were just scrambling everywhere. We knew we were small with Mike being injured. So we just wanted to keep playing hard and putting the pressure on them. Dribble drive was working for us tonight, and defending and helping one another. Help defense was real good tonight for us.
You mentioned the dribble drive. Certainly, you seem to have a nose for the rim, oftentimes finding yourself matched up against the center or the power forward for the Spurs when you guys were in that small ball lineup. Was that a conscious effort on your part to consistently keep attacking the paint?
Yes, Coach put the ball in my hands once they seen them, kept switching for me. So I just wanted to be aggressive and take what the defense gave me, and I feel like a big man guarding me at the top of the key, I can get by him and create for my teammates.
Your teammates, multiple players stepped up tonight and contributed in a major way. Jamil, to yourself, all finishing with right around 20 points or plus. What does it mean to be able to come after last night's blowout loss and come out here and get a true team victory?
It's big. We dropped four of them, so it was big for us to come out and play hard tonight. We believe in each other. Like, we got a good team. Everybody get along well. And we just wanted to help each other, keep each other confident and positive. So Coach just said we got to let that one go yesterday and just come out and play hard tonight.
Pat, thank you for your time. Thank you for your effort tonight. We'll face the Spurs again this coming Wednesday. We're going to take a quick break. When we return, Jared Sandler wraps things up as the Legends take on the Spurs and take them down tonight inside Dr. Pepper Arena.
Welcome back to Texas Legends Basketball as we continue our North Texas Trailer postgame show. Time now for the Mike Bowman Century 21 Difference Maker of the Game. And well, it's not Stephen Pledger or Two Holloway. It's the crowd. The crowd really getting after it. Late there, as you see, the final free throw and missed putback attempt. And the crowd there doing everything they could to distract the 76% free throw shooter, Nick Johnson. And it worked.
We discussed this a lot about how it's not the fans' responsibility to give it to the team. The team has to give it to the fans, and then it boomerangs back. But in that final free throw attempt, this is an advantage that you have here in Frisco. They don't do this at every D-League game. They don't have this building at every D-League game. They don't have this crowd at every D-League game. Y'all are the player of the game.
Well, there you go. Player of the game, the crowd. Contributions, though, from a lot of members of the Legends, shorthanded, and they did this, getting only 15 minutes from Brandon Ashley. One of their All-Stars, the other All-Star, Michael Eric, was out and unavailable due to an ankle injury. So the Texas Legends able to come away, maybe against the odds, to defeat the Austin Spurs. They snap a season-long four-game losing streak, and they move to 16-14 with the victory. For Mike Fisher, I'm Jared Sandler, and everyone else back in the truck, thanks for tuning in to Texas Legends Basketball on your home for Texas Legends Entertainment.